The Marine Corps contribution to the American population on Okinawa rests primarily with the 3rd Marine Division, a battle-tested division whose sole mission is to deploy on short notice anywhere in the Western Pacific as a part of the U.S.'s Force in Readiness. There are a number of supporting elements, including the Marine Air Station at Futima, which provides support to Marine Air Group 3C and their helicopters, which support the 3rd Division. On the northern part of the island, the Marines have a large training area stretching for miles across almost inaccessible, heavily wooded mountains. These port facilities in the White Beach area, which provide ships of the 7th Fleet with logistical services, an 800-foot typhoon-proof pier in Kin Bay for loading logistic supplies in the Tengan area, and headquarters fleet activities, Okinawa, at Naha Air Base, where anti-submarine warfare and sea surveillance missions for the 7th Fleet are planned and executed. The primary mission of the Air Force on Okinawa is to support and operate fighter, tanker, and cargo aircraft for the defense of the Western Pacific area. Kadena, once a small Japanese airfield and one of the first objectives of our invasion forces, has grown into this sprawling complex. One of the largest and best-equipped Air Force bases in the world, housing both operational and support facilities for activities in the Western Pacific, with shops, repair facilities, medical facilities, housing, clubs, golf courses, commissary, chapels, schools, exchanges. And just outside Gate 2, is the city of Kosa. Here you have easy access to a variety of shopping facilities, much like those found in any similar stateside city. Although Kadena will seem centrally located to you, a look at a map of this 70-mile-long island reveals that it is located in the south-central part of the island. The bulk of the 800,000 population is centered in the southern half. Nago, with a population of nearly 50,000, is the only large city in the northern part. Most of the north is unpopulated, but parts of it can be reached on secondary roads. The natural scenery is outstanding. It is possible, with a break in traffic and some good weather, to cover the island north to south in one day. Starting with the cliff at the southern tip of the island, where the final bitter moments of the Battle of Okinawa were played out. All that remains today are the memorials erected by various prefectures to the men who died. The largest fishing village on Okinawa. The ruins of old castles dating back to the 15th and 16th centuries. The beaches. Turtleback tombs scattered across the island. Some of these tombs are hundreds of years old and are considered sacred by the people. If you are an aficionado, you'll be able to see a bullfight nearly every weekend. One slight difference, however. On Okinawa, the bulls fight each other. The men in the arena act only as handlers. Booming entertainment and tourist industry has grown up. The price is high if you don't use reasonable care. Today's Okinawans are a composite of the old and the new. East and the West. As with people everywhere, they are responsive to courtesy and consideration. A friendly, self-respecting people who strive to maintain a productive society. Little is known of the origin of the Ryukyuan people. Like their early history, their origin is locked in legend. One theory is that they are principally of Japanese aborigine stock. Another is that they are of Malaysian ancestry. Whatever their ancestry, the Ryukyuans are a friendly and hardy people, used to the ravages and abuse from both natural and human forces. Their complex culture, predominantly Japanese, is laced with early Chinese associations and strongly influenced by a large American population. Their cultural life has traditionally been filled with concern for nature and family and their interrelationship with the spirits and man. The United States helped the Ryukyuans climb from the devastation of World War II to attain one of the highest per capita incomes in Asia. Giant strides were made in many other areas. This obvious goodwill, coupled with the Ryukyuans' fear of being drawn into future wars because of American military presence, has caused considerable confusion to the Ryukyuans. Confusion that has led to demonstrations by union and labor groups. The 27 years of U.S. influence are history now. With the reversion of Okinawa to Japan in May 1972, control of the Ryukyu Islands passed from the United States to the Japanese government. With this change came the use of Japanese yen for most purchases on the economy. Okinawa is now one of the 47 prefectures under the administration of the Japanese government. A status of forces agreement is in effect. You are the guest of a foreign government and subject to its laws and regulations. There may be other changes in the future requiring both restraint and discipline on your part. But there is nothing in the regulations stating that you must enjoy your tour here, or for that matter, like the people. You could spend all your time in the large American community and never realize you are away from the States. But if you have an empathy for people and the desire to learn about new cultures, new customs, and new traditions, you'll find this could be one of the most rewarding tours of your career. You have a great responsibility in the accomplishment of the United States Mutual Security Pact with the government of Japan. The contribution made during your stay on Okinawa is of vital importance to the present and future security of the East Asian region. Pacific, and will remain so for many years to come.